Today I'm going to show you how to add and remove columns from the pivot view of a sumo table. For a moment, let's imagine that I'm an HR manager and this is my dashboard. I've got a lot of really great metrics here to help me make good business decisions, in particular this overall conversion funnel that helps me understand how candidates are moving through our recruiting process. What this doesn't show me, however, is how effective my individual recruiters are in recruiting the right people to fill our open positions within our organization. To understand this, I'll want to know how long these individuals that have recruited for these positions stick around within our organization. And I think this will be a good use case to use a sumo table on, in particular, the pivot view. So I'm going to actually add a new card. I'm going to use the sumo table to do so. I'm going to select the data set that I know has my information, which is Talio Recruiting. And here within the sumo table editor, I can actually see the pivot view here on the left-hand side. From here, I can select the categories and values that I want to use to build my pivot view. And I've got a couple of different ways that I can actually add these individual categories and or values into their respective spots. I can simply drag them into place, remove them using the X if needed, or I can also double click and it will add that respective category that I'm looking for. So for this particular example, I want to see how recruiters are at retention, and in particular, those that have filled jobs. You can see here on the right-hand side, individual recruiters broken out by their different retention metrics. And I can quickly at a glance see how each recruiter is in each of those areas. If I want additional granularity, I can bring in another field like department and see how the retention within each department also works. And this is how you can remove and add columns within the pivot view of a sumo table.